Okay, welcome back, guys. If any of you are with me with my Minecraft building, we are still a go. Unfortunately, we don't have a backup, but I was able to go into spectator mode and get my head out of that brick. Yeah. So we will be able to continue building everything, and I actually mostly finished the building. I left a little bit to show some of the YouTubers, and we'll probably get back to that tomorrow because I'm hoping to start doing the basement and a couple other things, as well as show off some thumb crafts so they're not so far behind. Once they catch up, I got a couple more options I can do. So in the meantime, what we're going to do for the rest of the night, which will probably be about another hour or so, is try a couple games of death. Now, if you're familiar with games like Evolve or I'm sorry, I forgot the name of it, but it was like a zombie game that came out recently, After Dark or something like that. Anyways, this game is a four diver versus two shark game. Each one's played slightly differently. But they just came out with a new update that brings out a whole new shark, one I've never played before. So we might be trying that. I want to try to play at least a couple games with the shark, the new one, to try him out. And afterwards, we might try to diver a little bit, but I'm not as great with them. Oh, right. There is two different game modes. Blood and Gold tends to be the standard one. And Megalodon Hunt is kind of like your shark is a juggernaut type thing. I think they start out like fully evolved or something like that. Don't play too much of it, honestly. So, it'll shoot the shark. I'm going to warn you that the sharks usually take a bit to load. To find a match. Everybody wants to be a shark, nobody really wants to be a diver. So we'll take a couple minutes here to find the shark. Ooh, that was actually quicker than I expected. And once that's once we do a game or two with this one, we'll try a couple with the diver, and that will be almost instantaneous. Builds are pretty simple. The diver is basically escort the unmanned vehicle and pick up treasure as they go. As they do, and as they bring treasure back to Steve, they gain money. As they gain money, they gain access to weapons, gadgets, etc. that help them survive. That's kind of cool. Now I only have the default skin, but you can buy other skins too. But there's basically three different types. The Great White, which is a slow behemoth, but bites really hard and is really tough. The Mako, which is really small, but he's fast. And I believe he has like a tail whip ability that's kind of an AoE against divers. The tiger is also it's kind of like the DPS shark of the group. Plus, if memory serves, I believe he can kind of camouflage. And then you have the hammerhead, which didn't have a whole lot of bite to it, but one of the hidden things about the hammerhead is that he ran a diver into the wall. Then he ends up doing a massive amount of damage. So we can kind of see Steve there. And you find each... Really? Wow. Looks like we did manage to kill him, though, so we do get an evolution point. Okay, that allows us to detect people a little bit better. Probably didn't want to get that right away, but like I said, each shark is slightly different, so it's kind of a thing of finding what's the best way to get around fast. Some sharks are better at sprinting, others do better in a controlled or constant quick swim. Got shot once or twice. Which is not the end of the world by any means. There is ways for sharks to gain more life, but though I don't know if we're going to be doing it here. Let's see what this rage is about. Man, he survived. That's the other thing. Sharks only gain points when they actually kill a human. I can kill a seal and gain some health, or not necessarily a seal, but something seal-like, and gain some health from eating. But that doesn't necessarily mean that I'll gain evolution points. In fact, in most cases, I won't. So there's... Wow. There's two ways to for the sharks to win the game. You'll see the numbers at the top there, but basically they have 24 guys left. We have 23 sharks left. That may seem slightly unfair because that technically means they have a two-person advantage, but they still go through it really fast. I can destroy some of their stuff. Like that there was a sensor buoy, I think. Really? Tell me I at least got the diver. Ah! Unlike the sharks, the humans do heal rather fast. So, that's unfortunate. Let's see here. I hate to say this, but I'm pretty sure my teammate is kind of pulling me right now. But we'll see you later. The other way that the humans can win is they can, or the other way that the sharks can win is that they end up destroying Steve, which is not as easy as it sounds. I'm really hurt. I think they're probably going to kill me like one shot if I... don't get something to eat first. Look at him go, dude. I think he just got like two or three of them at once. Well, I got him, but they still managed to shoot me. This one is kind of a nice one. Basically, I can start healing on my own slightly. Not very fast, mind you, but... Something there is throwing off sharky interference here. Got one of them at least. One of them is using a waller, which means that, in all likelihood, killing Steve is not going to be likely, because that guy could start fixing Steve. Going to just respawn for now. Probably should have just did my all sharks have the same evolutions with the exception of their unique evolution. That's different for each one, and it has three different stages. I probably should have done that. Okay, you see how it says the Haven was almost ours again? That means we're about to win. Correction, we did win. So yeah, he got 30 kills and 1 assist. I got 4. So he definitely carried me there. Once the sharks can actually get on a pretty good roll once they get going. Whereas the humans... have to get some money to get their weapons. Once they get their weapons, any excess gold they can kind of put into miscellaneous gear, but then they kind of cap out. Once you have a fully automatic weapon, you don't really need much more. Or rather, there's not much way to improve it. I think they can get... No, correction, I know they can get upgrades for them, but they're still limited. I know divers with poison bullets, for example, are a real massive pain in the rear. But yeah, they got a fully equipped thing here. Basically, the way I kill something is I have to A, first bite it, and B, then I just start wiggling my mouse around. It says you can do this. I find it better to do circles. That's just me. They can tag us, they have flares, they have sonar bullets, they have a variety of ways of finding us. But like I said, most of that we can destroy. The tagging is probably the worst because most of the other stuff is short range, and I can just swim out of their viewing range. But if they can tag me, those bullets travel pretty damn fast. So, most of it is pretty self-explanatory. The individual evolutions is kind of dependent on the shark. The species-specific evolution is obviously dependent on the shark, but these are different levels of usefulness depending on which shark you are. I don't think I need Homo aquatics because they usually are around Steve. So I'll just ready up, I think. Yeah, save the points. Then I can get the healing ones easier. This one is a really nice one, too. They're element modifiers, like the tag I just mentioned, and they also have like poison and bleeding bullets. All are less effective, which is amazingly useful. Because I tell you, that the poison bullets are really nasty. I think the bleeding ones will actually hurt you more, but I think poison will actually kill you. And you may actually get away or kill the guy who shot you. Oh boy, it's been a while since I've been to this map. Uh-oh, somebody shot me already. Yeah. One of the main things with the sharks is you kind of want the element of surprise, but if they start shooting at you before you're within range, then you got a problem. This is especially true if you're the tiger shark, because he's not exactly the most durable shark out there, but his stealth makes him very good at getting surprises. I'm not sure if they can see me here or not. Let's just see if any of them show up. Doesn't look like they can. Okay. I was able to get the surprise on that one guy because he wasn't looking in the bushes, at least not well enough. But they did manage to get me once I lashed out. I know the sharks seem big and mean and like they're the badasses, but you really want to be hitting and running when you can. Some things like these metal barriers here are actually kind of nice because we can sort of sense them behind it. They can't sense us, and we can bust through and fight them at the same time. What the heck? I got to admit, I've never seen that before. It looked like some sort of auto turret or something, but I'm not sure. It does make a certain amount of sense, though. They come out with a new shark, they have to get the dive or something new. Question is it still there? Yes, it is. And yes, by the way, bullets hurt. Okay, so they moved on, which is good. Oh, crap. That there is a seal. I can use that to heal myself if I could catch it. Where'd it go? It's also sometimes fun just to do structural damage when the divers be by. Scare the heck out of them. makes him a bit paranoid, if you know what I mean. Oh! Oops! I accidentally drove that dagger into his own mind. That actually may not be bad. Yeah. I was gonna go with the healing one, but that may not be bad. And I can use seals to heal if necessary. The other map, I didn't find any seals. The thing that really sucks is that bubble right there, we have a really hard time sensing anything inside of it. I'm not entirely sure what just hit me, but okay. Problem is, they have 8 more guys, and they're about 3/4 of the way done now. Ah, crap. See what I mean about those poison bullets? That's a knife. Impressive. Yeah, that art just really suck. We're gonna go with impressive though, because that sounds better. Oh, they have a turret there. Of course they do. I'm not sure those serrated teeth were worth it. By the way, I ran the Steve. If I ran Steve, it actually stuns it for a moment, so that's a good way of slowing them down. Of course, that generally helps if I'm not being, you know, shot at that time. I think I got one of them and ran Steve at the same time, so. Oh, it didn't give me the evolution points for it. Damn. I must have got him with the teeth but not actually killed him. Or at least not while I was alive. Sometimes if the sharks work together, it can be really nice because what just happened there is one of them got hit by my friend and they all focused on him. And then I can hit the others as they are focusing on my friend. This here is their last stop, and then they have to get this thief to the extraction point. But there's only 3 of them left. And final kill. Again, my friend kind of carried me, but that was significantly better than last time. Now let's see here. I think we got time for one more game. This time I'll try a diver. Keep in mind I'm usually playing a shark, so I'm gonna suck at this. Thank you. Now, as a favor, I think, like last time, we get gold, or rather money, for killing sharks. But I think we also get it for collecting gold that's scattered across the ground and bring it back to Steve. I wouldn't say the detail they put into all the descriptions is great, but it is pretty accurate and a good idea to figure out what it is. That one there would be nice to get, but you have to be like level 29, and I'm 27, so I'm not far off. That's the turret there. That's $600, whereas a pistol is about $500, so it's not too bad for a consumable. Not sure if something you'd want to start off right away, but. Your harpoon shotgun, and there are different upgrades they can get too. Some bleed, some poison. I'm not really sure you'd want to use a scope in this game because it's pretty hard to see a shark far away, but that's just me. That one's not terrible, but it can get nasty if you're a shark who focuses on running away, because that cuts your stamina in half, basically. Let's see here. I don't usually see people use that one very often. This, the DPB and the sensor sometimes, but. That one's also kind of nasty. It's kind of like a knife, but even if they don't kill you, you're still dead. On the bright side, it is expensive and you have to be pretty high level to get it. Like it says here, you do start off with either a knife or a welder. The welder can repair Steve, so that's good for a support type person. Usually it doesn't take this long to do a diver, huh? That's pretty good for a support type person. The welders do nearly no damage to the sharks. I mean, you did see me die that one time to the guy with the welder, but chances are I got shot a couple of times in the meantime. You got your automatic rifles too. These ones in particular can't be my personal favorite, but the thing to point out here is it says what it lacks in stopping power, which suggests that it's a really weak gun. Yeah, most of these automatic rifles put out enough bullets that, well, let's face it, bullets hurt. I don't care how powerful they are, you get hit by two or three of them, you're usually dead, even if you're a shark. There we go. Welcome to the stream, Mole. Okay, so there's Steve. There's my party members. There's some gold. Yeah. You gotta be careful with getting too far away from the group. I guess driving me into a landmine is one way of killing me, yeah? Night one for you, Mole. Somebody finally got me, but I got 3 kills in a row, so that's something. We'll save up for that one. had bleeding teeth. I must have died or bled out. Night vision scope might be useful. I got lucky there. If I hadn't seen him coming straight at me, I probably would have been dead. It does kind of tell me which direction they're coming, though. Oh, I still bled out even though I was standing still. Interesting. I at least got an assist on him, but from that far range it was hard to hit him. The tricky part is when we're in between spots like this, it's pretty easy for them to get us since we're out in the open. In the tunnels isn't as bad, but in some maps where you're swimming from one boat to the next, wow, you can get taken out really easily. Oh, thanks, Varanthus. Didn't know that. I knew he was bleeding me, but I didn't know he was actually, it was a permanent thing. I thought it would wore off. Well, you guys are still there. One more for the shark, or one more as a diver? Oh, we got the bank stick unlocked. Yeah, I bet. Thank you. Maybe we should just do either. See if, what luck is this. That seems like the way to go, then. I'm guessing, judging from the way we were going through matches earlier, we're probably going to be a shark. Because they had, like, next to no wait time while I waited, like, 2 minutes for a diver. I could be mistaken. Piece that was a pretty nice one too. 50 points to buy it though. Okay, diver it is. Gotta admit, that's a kind of curious design for a gun, but I suppose the fewer moving parts of the water, the better. That's not good. They're catching up on me being quick. Oh, That's a fair amount of gold to get started. Now, where are they coming from? Right on top of us. Where are they? Oh, there's one. There's the other. Did I just knife kill both of them? Oh no, somebody shot them while they were biting me. That works. He was right here. Where'd he go? Yeah. Oh, that's interesting. Are you an underwater diver, Ramses? Not sure how to pronounce that right. Where are they at? Well, still, that's kind of cool. I've only dived once, and it was kind of limited. You know, just basically swimming through a reef. So, my experience is virtually null and void. Oh, there he is. For all that heart thumping, he should have. He was probably here for quite a while. And his friend is apparently not far off. Oh, he just got taken down the tunnels. There's no way we're gonna help him. Got him, though. The sharks really know their map. They can come at us right after one, right after the other. So it's not a whole lot of. Looks like we got each other. That's enough to give me my gun, at least. The ammo types I want, though. Saw that. Where'd it go? Oh, crap.
probably should have been looking for gold too while I was waiting for the sharks to get here. Oh well. Some gold at least. I don't want to be the last one around here either. That direction, you think? Most likely. Yep, definitely that direction. Oh! Nice. One of them was a distraction and ran away while the other one came at us. I was kind of on my own in that one. Not surprised. Did I buy the right one? I must not have. I meant to grab the turret, but I think I grabbed the scanner instead or something. Something at the last minute, but not enough. Turret. No, I meant to buy the turret. Just couldn't place it down, I guess. There we go. That's my first time actually using the turret, so I'm not sure if it got placed right. Apparently you did. I'll take it. Yeah, he's right on top of this one. Ooh. Right behind me. Got lucky there. Oh, not so much that time. I should really turn around, seeing that they're coming from above us. A little bit too late to actually use that, but okay. Okay, guys, it's a little bit after midnight now. Well, actually, it's closer to midnight 30. So I think I'm going to call up here for tonight.